Welcome to easyayurveda.com. Let us learn how to do multitasking in a healthy Ayurveda way. Living in this 21st century wired world, we cannot live without multitasking. Just try to organize yourself to do only one thing at a time. By afternoon, your day will start going every. There are opinions that multitasking is not good for health and it causes attention deficit, it induces panic, etc. But there is surely a healthy Ayurveda way of doing many things at a time without losing your mind. Ayurveda concept of mind. As per Ayurveda, there are two characteristics of mind. One is anuttva or minuteness. Mind is minute and moves very fast to link with different sense organs, hands and legs. Second is ekatva or single. Mind is only one. Mind is the coordinator between sense organs and intellect. Mind and intellect should be in unison for knowledge inflow, that is sensory action, or inward flow of message from external world to brain. And second one, motor action, that is outward flow of message from brain to sense organs, hands and legs, etc., to take action. When mind connects between eyes and intellect, we see and perceive things. When mind connects between ears and intellect, we hear and understand things. When mind connects our hands with intellect, we can write what we want to express. The above type of three actions, like seeing and perceiving, hearing and understanding, and writing to express something. Let us call this type of action as full mindful actions. Full mindful actions are those where we cannot do anything without full involvement of mind. For example, if mind does not connect between eyes and intellect, we may be looking at an object, but we cannot perceive it. We may be hearing, but we cannot understand things. We may be writing, but we cannot write to express our ideas. However, each and every action of ours may not require our mind's full participation. I'll call such works as semi-mindful actions. There are some works for which continuous connection of organs with intellect is not required. For example, walking. Mind decides where to go and where to stop. It hands over the responsibility to legs. Legs will take care of walking, while mind may indulge in any other work, like listening to something. This is why you can consciously listen to what your friend is talking about while you are walking. Note here, though mind is presently connecting ears to intellect, it has assigned the walking job to legs and that job is going on smoothly. Apart from working with sense organs, hands and legs, mind also does thinking, planning, guessing, analyzing, etc. So with this background, let us come back to the multitasking. How to multitask like a pro? Because mind is only one, you simply cannot take up two full mindful actions at the same time. For example, you cannot drive and answer a phone call at the same time. It causes accidents. Because driving is a full mindful action, there are a lot of decisions to make. And listening, thinking and talking is again another full mindful actions. So no two full mindful actions at the same time. But you can surely combine one semi-mindful action and one full mindful action. You can do these two types of actions at one time. For example, you can surely drive while you're listening to music, can't you? Driving is full mindful job. But listening to music is only a semi-mindful job. You're not totally into the music. It just runs in the background and you only feel the enjoyment without bothering much about what the lyrics is all about and so on. So follow this simple principle and pick only two tasks at a time, one full mindful and another semi-mindful, and enjoy multitasking. Let's take up some examples for good multitasking. Putting clothes to washing machine and cooking. Once you put clothes into washing, your mind is not required there. It is semi-mindful action. You can continue cooking, which is a full mindful action. Downloading a big size software while you type an email. Once you hit the download button and assign a disk space in your laptop, you're free till the download is complete. Use that time to type, browse, drink a cup of coffee, etc. Jogging and listening to a self-help podcast. Jogging does not require your full mind. It requires only your semi-mind. You can utilize that full attention of your mind to listen to podcast related to your favorite topic. Reading a document while enjoying a cup of herbal tea. You can surely do both things together unless you end up spilling tea over your important document. Next, examples of bad multitasking. Driving and talking over the phone. They just cannot simply coexist with each other. Students doing homework while watching TV. TV being more interesting and engaging, mind will be dragged into it, harming the progress of your homework. Eating and texting or talking over the phone. As per Ayurvedic eating etiquette, eating should be your full mindful job. You should concentrate on quality and quantity of stuff going into your mouth. Talking over the phone being more active job is a full mindful job and you cannot combine with it with eating. So basic prerequisites of a successful multitasking. Measurement of time. As a perfect plan, if you do not plan the task ahead, you will not be able to achieve a healthy mix of semi and full mindful jobs. It is better to plan early in the morning or just before going to sleep. Measurement of time. As your experience grows, you should have a clear picture regarding precisely how much time is required to complete one task. Next, write it down. Writing down the future tasks as and when you think of one is a very healthy habit. You can even use your mobile phone to make a note of your plannings for your day. So use these simple techniques and become a champion of multitasking without losing your mind. For more such tips and tricks, please visit easyayurveda.com.